Shalom, and welcome to Bible Stories as Blueprints of the Soul, your Biblical Hebrew podcast. Shalom, and welcome to our Biblical Hebrew podcast. What is so special about the number 10,000 in Hebrew? Usually when we speak of the Hebrew alphabet, we have learned that for every letter, there is also a number that reflects the quality of the letter. So we have letters on one hand, and on the other hand, we have numbers. Interestingly, the number 10,000 in Hebrew also has a name, Revava. Revava. The word Revava we can divide into two words, Rav, many, Ba, in it or in her. The word Revava we find in the speech of Ezekiel, chapter 16, verse 7. And so says Ezekiel, Revava ketzemach hasadeh netatich, meaning 10,000, I gave you the potential to grow like a plant of the field. And the question is, who has the potential to grow like a plant of the field? The Hebrew Bible says, Revava, meaning 10,000. But what is this number, 10,000? Let's look carefully into the structure of the number 10,000. Mathematically speaking, 10 in the power of 2, meaning 10, double 10, gives us the volume of 100. Now, 10 in the power of 3, meaning 10, double 10, double 10, gives us the volume of 1,000. In Hebrew, 1,000 is Elif. Elif. The same letters that we write the word Elif, which is 1,000, with the same letters we write the word Aleph. Aleph, which is the first letter in the Hebrew alphabet. So, let's go back again. 10 in the power of 3, meaning 10, double 10, double 10, equals 1,000 in Hebrew, Aleph, but also Aleph. So whenever we find the combination or the structure of 1,000 or 10 in the power of 3, which is an odd number, 3, we find implication to the 1, to the letter Aleph, to the source. Now, let's continue. 10 in the power of 4, meaning 10, double 10, double 10, double 10, gives us the volume of 10,000. 10,000. In Hebrew, aseret alafim. Aseret alafim. Eser is 10, and alafim are thousands. Now, so what does it mean, aseret alafim, 10,000? It means, if we double the volume of 1,000 10 times, we get 10,000. But each thousand equals Aleph, also the letter Aleph. So 10,000 means 10 times we write the letter Aleph. Aleph, One time is 1,000. Aleph, two times is 2,000. Aleph, three times mean 3,000s. Aleph, four times means 4,000s, and so on. So instead of writing or saying 10,000s, we write 10 times the letter Aleph. And when we write 10 times the letter Aleph, the other person knows he can think about those 10 letters Aleph as the sum of 10,000. This is one aspect of the speech. The second aspect, who or what is 10,000? Like Ezekiel named this number Revava. Who has the potential of Revava? 10,000. And as we said before, 10,000 is, mathematically speaking, 10 in the power of 4. So who of all of these components has this structure or has this ability to grow like a plant of the field from 1 to 10 to 10,000, or from 1 to 4? Because 10,000 is 10 in the power of 4. And the answer is simple. Revava, which Ezekiel says, refers to the soul, the human soul, neshama. The human soul is named in Hebrew as revava, 10,000s. 10 in the power of 4, the expansion from 1 to 4. So, in other words, the speech of Ezekiel, chapter 16, verse 7, refers to the human soul. Ezekiel turned in his speech to the human soul, to the human spirit. And its name in Hebrew is Revava, Revava. The word Revava is written in Hebrew with 4 letters, Resh, Bet, Bet, He. And we can divide those 4 letters into 2 words, Rav, meaning many, and Ba, in it or in her. There is the potential, the immense potential in a human soul. This is why Ezekiel named it Revava. So, this was our little conversation for today. I hope it was not too complex to catch. But if you stop the video and you can write things down, it makes sense, and you're always welcome to ask us more and more questions. We're wishing you a beautiful day and wonderful week. Thank you for listening to Bible Stories as Blueprints of the Soul. We hope that you enjoyed this episode. If you have any questions, comments, or would like to hear more about a certain topic, just write us an email to Hebrew@learnoutlife.com. We are always happy to hear from you. For more episodes, videos, and articles like this, please visit our website at Hebrew.learnoutlife.com. We also would like to invite you to join our live classes. Just search for Online College of Biblical Hebrew on Facebook and start learning now with students from all over the world. Kol Tuv and Shalom.